جاي من كل مكان، الصويرة زينة البلدان، زورو ونرجع فرحان. كفى بالو للهلولة، حوض السلاح حوضو محيلة، نضربو شوفارة الليلة.
بشوت مغيب غابوتاي، بشوت غاب شريطة. Well, as we say, Blabas, we have only a few 2 days for before the end of Hanukkah. And what we did learn this week from Hanukkah, besides that we did the Hallel, special praise every day, there is a Sefer Torah, but what is left? What do we learn from Hanukkah? You know, Rabotai, I would like to tell you a small story about a tzaddiket. She was the sister of the Chazon Ish. And you know, 70 years ago, to have milk, a fresh milk in Bnei Brak, it was not easy. And one day she had a glass of milk. She bought it, she collected some money, and then she had a baby, she bought a glass of milk. And when she came home, she heard the voice of the Chazon Ish, her brother, that he was studying Torah. So she started to think, that glass of milk, should I give it to my son, or I give it to my brother? And the husband, he told her, what are you doing in the steps? Why don't you come in? I'm thinking, what to do with this glass of milk? For our son or for my brother? So he told her, of course, your son is a baby. Your brother is an old man. So she told him, the difference is, my son, if he drink it, will not drink it, he will live. But my brother is a tzaddik. That glass of milk, it can give him more strength to study some Torah. Maybe he deserves more the milk than my daughter, our son. Can you imagine, Rabotai, this kind of thoughts that a mother can think to prefer her brother, to give the milk to the brother, to her son? This is something that you cannot understand. We should know one thing, that Hanukkah, if today, Baruch Hashem, Am Israel, we're living, Baruch Hashem, we've been in Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Libya, Iraq, in Europe, Russia, China, everywhere, Iran, and Baruch Hashem, we're still here. The only reason is because we had Torah with us. Wherever we went, we took the Sefer Torah with us. This is the only thing that keeps us together. This is the only thing that it keeps us as a nation. This is Hanukkah. Hanukkah is to remind you that Hashem Yishmor, if there is no Torah, you lost. If there is no Torah, you lost. And this is, Rabotai, something that we must understand. And something, when you see Sarah Imenu and it's Hakabino, I would like just to tell you this. This separation from our brothers, it started already 1,000 years ago. When Sarah Imenu, she saw Ishmael, that he was the son of Abraham Abino. And she saw him, he was playing games. He was doing I don't think that he was doing really Avodah Zarah, idolatry, because Ishmael cannot do Avodah Zarah in the house of Abraham Abinu. I mean, Abraham Abinu was a big fighter against Avodah Zarah. His son Ishmael would do Avodah Zarah, but he was playing, he was having more love, more attention, football games, you know, other things than the Torah. That's for Sarah Abinu, it's Avodah Zarah. It's Avodah Zarah. So when she saw Ishmael, just instead of going to wake up to go to shul on Minyan, Abraham Abinu has a big synagogue. Everybody comes to pray. ما تيش معي ال يوتش تلفزيون يش معي ويل بلاي جيمز يش معي ال يويل كول إيه يويل كول إز برادر إتسحاق in the middle of his study. Let's come, let's walk, let's have a small walk together. That Sarah, she didn't like it. And she said to Abraham, Abraham, those two brothers cannot live together. You have to separate them. Oh, it's impossible. And for Abraham, it was very, 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 very difficult to tell Ishmael, his son, get out from my house. And Hashem, he said to Abraham, listen to Sarah. What Sarah said to do, you should do it. Because if you want the relation of Torah, it can only come from Yitzhak. Because Yitzhak will teach his children the way to keep the Judaism. So, you see, so the separation started at that moment. When Avraham Avinu passed away, the one who buried Avraham Avinu, it was Yitzhak. Abino, because you see, the separation started already long time ago. And you see, when Yitzhak Abino, he wanted to give a bracha to Esav, and Yaakov took the bracha. Then Esav came, and he said to Yaakov, to his father, Papa, I want the bracha. And Yitzhak, he said, No. So Yaakov, your brother, he came, and he took your bracha. So Yitzhak, Esav, he starts to scream. There is only one bracha. No. The real bracha, Yaakov took it. And from that beginning, Esav, he couldn't stand Yaakov Abinu. He started to hate him. He wanted to kill him. The question is, why Yitzhak you did that? Why you did that? Why you told Esav that Yaakov took the bracha? Just don't say nothing. Give him another bracha. No discussion. So there'll be no sinat hinam, no hate between two brothers. Why you did that? The reason was because Yitzhak Avinu realized that that Yaakov and Esav cannot live together. He remember that was the idea of Sarai Minu, that Ishmael and Yitzhak, they cannot live together. So now is the repetition of the history. Esav and Yaakov, they cannot live together. It's impossible. Because if they live together, both of them they'll be assimilated. It's easy to do bad things than doing good things. So it's better that to separate them. So Rabotai, even Bil'am HaRasha, that's what he said. Ki Am Israel, Am Libadad Ishkon. The Jews, they are only one nation. They live together and they will not mix with others. Not because they hate them. No. This is the only way to keep Torah and Mitzvot is by being all together. And this is Rabotai, when the Jews, they started, when the Yavan, the Greek, they came to Eretz Israel, and they started to be friendly with the Bnei Israel, with the Jews, it started, it started very, very, very light. Look, my friend, the word Yavan, I was thinking this 2 weeks ago, Yavan. You write Yavan with a Yud and a Vav and a Nun Sufit. You see, they are the same letters. It's just the Yud, it's a small letter. The Vav, it's like the Yud, but it's a little bit longer. And the Nun Sufit, it's like the Yud, but it's more longer than the Vav and the Yud. This is what the Torah wants to teach us, that we call the Yavanim, the Greek, as the darkness. They brought darkness. At the beginning, when they came to the Jews, they came just to be friendly with them, like a Yud. And the Jews, because they did not take more attention about this, so they started to mix with them, play with them, have a coffee with them. So now the Yavanim, they started to give more influence, like a Vav, a little bit more, a little bit further, a little bit more friendship. Let's go to have an Olympic Games. And then when the Greek, they saw that the Bnei Israel started to be very friendly with them, so that now their influence was stronger. Not to study Torah, it's already Nun Sufit. It's like this is the Yitzhak. The Gemara said the Yitzhak, he never starts. He will never come to tell me, hey, Pinto, David, go and do Avera. because he knows that I will not listen to him. I will not listen to him. But he can't tell me, hey, David, don't wake up this morning, you are tired. You know, you didn't sleep all night. You don't need, have some rest. This is the way he starts, with something that if you follow him, if you open the doors and you follow him, then the next step will be a little bit more stronger, then at the end will be in his hand. And that was the problem between the Greek and the Jews at that time, because they forgot that Sarai Menu, she separated Ishmael from Yaakov, from Yitzhak. They forgot that Yitzhak Avinu, he separated Yaakov from Esav. And now you are together. And that's what happened. And this is, Rabotai, that's what we remember every year. As you know, nearly every year, we always talk about Yosef HaTzadik being in Egypt on his own. Just to teach you, look, that even you can be on your own, in a place that there is no Jews, no Torah, nothing, but if you be careful, you study Torah, you keep Torah mitzvot, Ra'ad Yukno Shel Aviv, always feel Hashem is near you, Hashem is watching you, Hashem is looking at you. You know, my friend, I had a personal problem. Bemet, it was yesterday. A personal problem. I had some kind of etzara of something. I cannot tell you what. And then I said to myself, David, are you crazy? You have a beard. People think you are a tzaddik. People think that you are, and you think about that. I said, yes, you're right. So you always have to talk to yourself. The more Torah you study, the more mitzvot you do, when the Yetzirah comes to push you to do Avera, the Torah reminds you, hey, don't do it. Be ashamed. Be ashamed of yourself. There is Hashem who is looking at you. Ein ro'ah. Ve'oze shuma'at. There is eyes that watch you. There is eyes, there is a ear that they listen to what you say. Something that, but to feel all this, you must have Torah. If you don't have weapon, I mean, if there is an enemy in front of you, if you have no weapon, you're finished. The only weapon that we have in front of the Yetzara, Hanerot Halalu, Kodesh Hem. When we light the candles of the menorah, this beautiful light of the menorah, it takes us back a few thousand years ago. And we remind that all what happened to us is that friendship that we had with the Greek. And that friendship, he brought to us a big disaster. 52 years of domination of the Greek in Israel. Just imagine, there was no Jews. All the Jews, they forgot they were Jews. No Torah, no Beit HaMikdash, no Shabbat, no Brit Milah. All those who kept religion, they killed them. So there was nothing left. So that was the miracle of Hanukkah, that those Jews that they forgot, that they did even, it's like here, 2 days ago. There was a woman. I told her, did you like Hanukkah? She told me, yes, I saw Hanukkah. I saw in the street. I saw some houses Hanukkah. But did you like Hanukkah? She don't know what it is Hanukkah. I mean, even that she knows, yeah, Hanukkah. But no connection, nothing. She's disconnected. Why she came to see me? Only because she has a cancer. She's very, very bad. She's very, very ill. And somebody told her, go get a bracha. She don't even believe on nothing. That's what they were, the Jews, at the time, a few thousand years ago. They were with no Torah. It's impossible to recreate a nation with Torah without Torah. It's impossible. Yosef HaTzadik, he was in Egypt, a place where there is no Torah, but at least it was a Ben Torah. At least Yosef HaTzadik was a Ben Torah, so the Torah kept him. But those Jews, after 52 years of domination of the Greek and their land, they forgot how they started. How? That was the Nes. When the Jews, when when the Bnei Israel, they saw that the Hashmonaim light the candle and the menorah and the Beit HaMikdash, that went, you know, all Israel, they heard the news. All Israel heard the news. You know what? You know, the light and the menorah, she remained on lighting, you know. There was only for one day, now it's already 2 days. Yes, 2 days? Wow. And then he said, you know the news? The menorah and Beit HaMikdash still lighting. Yeah, no, it's not possible. Yes, wow. The 4 day, and that's the night. And so the Jews, they started to be more, no, it's still the menorah on. Yes, wow. Then the last day, after 8 days, they started to talk. No, what about the menorah? Well, today, Baruch Hashem, I think today they will put their own oil, because now they have that ness when somebody take attention about the mitzvah, that mitzvah help him. And I think this is the way I understand. The Jews, how they did teshuvah, how they rebuilt their nation, because they give themselves an opportunity of attention. So what's going on in the Beit HaMikdash? There is a nest there. Wow. After what's going on in the Beit HaMikdash? There is a nest there. So that news went everywhere in Israel, and that helped them. You start a little bit. You just do something. If you want to do teshuvah, you just start a little bit. Come forward to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu will help you. I know a lot of people, they were out of the derech. I promise you. I know hundreds of, or maybe thousands. They were out of the derech. When just you light them, just give them an opportunity. And if they take attention, that will help. But if there is no attention, just to look at you like this, it's like somebody, I was talking, and somebody was looking at me like this. No move, nothing. It was like a dead man. After, and I even said a beautiful story about a big tzaddik. No attention, nothing. He stand up, he left. Give you the Yetzer Hara, it will not help you to give attention to what you listen. The Yetzer Hara will tell you, it's rubbish, it's nothing. Pay some attention, think a little bit. You say Hashem will help you. That's what happened. Hashem, he did the Jews, the Hashmonaim, they did the first step. They look for the Shemen, they light the Shemen. You could have. There was a lot of shemen there, a lot of oil, but they didn't want to use it. They want a pure one. So they did a sacrifice. They did a move. They liked the shemen. So Hashem, when he saw their good attention, because they could light the menorah with another shemen, but they said no. So that good attention, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he loved it. So he said, okay, I will do something for you. I will give you a present. I will give you a gift. That menorah remained light. It did not switch off. That was, and that gave, you know, a news all over Israel. And then another news. And then, and that, and because the Jews, they give attention to that miracle, so Hashem, he helped them to do a big teshuvah. There is one day, a king, I will not mention to you which king this, he told me this. He said, I want a bracha from you. I said, why always you like brachot from the rabbis? We heard that always, even your father, your grandfather. What was his answer? His answer was, the brachot that you give, the rabbis give to people, they are very valuable, the shamayim. How do you know that? We know that. So if a non-Jew know that, how will I will not do that? Why a girl will know this? What about me? Why me I will not about this? Because he give attention, he pay attention, and he listen. And when you listen, you think. But unfortunately, we don't pay attention. We don't think. So we remain Hanukkah is to remind you. And they wrote Hallelujah, pay attention, look at them, think about what they did, look what happened, look how this light, it washed all the brain of the Jews at that time. So if that's what they did a long time ago, it could do them today. Rabotai, Shekel Shbochu, no, still have 2 days, huh? Bemeta. So I think you heard the Rav, the halachot, he said, oh, this week, and all that, and the main halacha is what I love about all this. I'm waiting, Bemeta, I'm very excited for tomorrow night. Tomorrow night is the last night when you will see the menorah, the 8 candles, light, you know, you look at them, and Nerot Halalu Kodeshem. Now you have the full price, the full lotto, the full mitzvah. It's in front of your eyes, and that's what you've been reaching. So now, what's next? Next, well, tomorrow there will be no Chanukah anymore. Tomorrow you will be the Chanukah. You will light yourself. Tomorrow you will be the continuation of this menorah. Up to now, you've been learning, teaching from this menorah. Now tomorrow, you have to learn from yourself. Tomorrow you'll be you on the menorah. You have to carry on. Carry on. Carry on. What you started from the first day you started with 1, from 1 to 2, from 2 to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and tomorrow it's you. And this is Chanukah. Chanukah is Be'ez Hashem to pay attention. If you pay attention to the Torah, you give a chance to understand, it will give you an open heart. The Torah will open your heart to believe in Hashem, to be close to Hashem, and to love Hashem. When Mashiach will come, what's going to happen? Nothing will happen. The word will carry on, like the Rabbam said. The Rabbam said, Olam kimin hagon ohek, the word will carry on the same way. But the difference will be that Mashiach will teach us that there is Hashem. Why today we don't know there is Hashem? Today there is Yitzhara. And Yitzhara is the one that he will do everything not to take attention, not to pay attention. So you don't see the real light. But Mashiach will come, Be'ezat Hashem, there will be no Yitzhara. So when you see something, that is from Hashem. There is nothing to disturb you. Shabbat Shalom, Baruch Hashem.